The Errors of Santa Claus by Stephen Leacock. It was Christmas Eve. The Browns, who lived in the adjoining house, had been dining with the Joneses. Brown and Jones were sitting over wine and walnuts at the table. The others had gone upstairs. "What are you giving your boy for Christmas?" asked Brown.
"A train," said Jones. "A new kind of thing, automatic."
"Let's have a look at it," said Brown. Jones fetched a parcel from the sideboard and began unwrapping it.
"An ingenious thing, isn't it?" he said. "Goes on its own rails. Queer how kids love to play with trains, isn't it?"
"Yes," assented Brown. "How are the rails fixed?"
"Wait, I'll show you," said Jones. "Just help me shove these dinner things aside and roll back the cloth. There, see? You lay the rails like that and fasten them at the ends. So,
oh yes, I catch on. It makes a grade, doesn't it? Just the thing to amuse a child, isn't it? I got Willie a toy aeroplane."
"I know, they're great. I got Edwin one on his birthday.
But I thought I'd get him a train this time. I told him Santa Claus was going to bring him something altogether new this time. Edwin, of course, believes in Santa Claus, absolutely. Say, look at this locomotive, would you? It has a spring coiled up inside the firebox." "Wind her up," said Brown with great interest. "Let's see her go."
"All right," said Jones. "Just pile up two or three plates or something to lean the end of the rails on. There.
Notice the way it buzzes before it starts. Isn't that a great thing for a kid, huh?"
"Yes," said Brown.
"And say, see this little string to pull the whistle? By gad, it toots, eh? Just like real."
"Now then, Brown," Jones went on, "you hitch on those cars, and I'll start her. I'll be engineer, eh?"
Half an hour later, Brown and Jones were still playing trains on the dining room table. But their wives upstairs in the drawing room hardly noticed their absence. They were too much interested. "I think it's perfectly sweet," said Mrs. Brown. "Just the loveliest doll I've seen in years. I must get one like it for Ulvina. Won't Clarice be perfectly enchanted?" "Yes," answered Mrs. Jones. "And then she'll have all the fun of arranging the dresses. Children love that so much. Look, there are three little dresses with the doll. Aren't they cute? All cut out and ready to stitch together. Oh, how perfectly lovely," exclaimed Mrs. Brown. "I think the mauve one would suit the doll best, don't you? With such golden hair. Only don't you think it would make it much nicer to turn back the collar so? And to put a little band so?" "What a good idea," said Mrs. Jones. "Do let's try it. Just wait. I'll get a needle in a minute. I'll tell Clarice that Santa Claus sewed it himself. The child believes in Santa Claus, absolutely." And half an hour later, Mrs. Jones and Mrs. Brown were so busy stitching dolls' clothes that they could not hear the roaring of the little train up and down the dining table and had no idea what the four children were doing. Nor did the children miss their mothers.
"Dandy, aren't they?"
Edwin Jones was saying to little Willie Brown as they sat in Edwin's bedroom.
100 in a box with cork tips and, see, an amber mouthpiece that fits into a little case at the side. Good present for Dad, eh?"
"Fine," said Willie appreciatively. "I'm giving Father cigars."
"I know. I thought of cigars, too. Men always like cigars and cigarettes. You can't go wrong on them. Say, would you like to try one or two of these cigarettes? We can take them from the bottom. You'll like them. They're Russian. Away ahead of Egyptian."
"Thanks," answered Willie. "I'd like one immensely. I only started smoking last spring on my 12th birthday. I think a feller's a fool to begin smoking cigarettes too soon, don't you? It stunts him. I waited till I was 12.
"Me too," said Edwin, as they lighted their cigarettes. "In fact, I wouldn't buy them now if it weren't for Dad. I simply had to give him something from Santa Claus. He believes in Santa Claus absolutely, you know."
And while this was going on, Clarice was showing little Ulvina the absolutely lovely little bridge set that she got for her mother.
"Aren't these markers perfectly charming?" said Ulvina. "And don't you love this little Dutch design? Or is it Flemish, darling?"
"Dutch," said Clarice.
"Isn't it quaint? And aren't these the dearest little things for putting the money in when you play? I needn't have got them with it. They'd have sold the rest separately. But I think it's so utterly slow playing without money, don't you?"
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.